Hi, welcome to Code Conversations. Today we're talking to Syed Abraham Hashimi. What are you going to show us today, Syed?
Hey, John. Today we're going to be talking about open source templates for .NET. And you know, I've been working in the open source space for templates for several years now. Here's some of my kind of big efforts. So you know, we created Sidewaffle back in August 2013. And that was a way to create templates and share templates with people inside Visual Studio. Mm-hmm. You know, and then ASP.NET Core popped up, and then we said, hey, we really need an experience, a cross-platform experience for, you know, creating these projects. So what we did there was basically there's a very popular Yeoman tool, and that's like the scaffolder for the web is what they call it. And in July 2014 was our kind of when we started that effort, and you know, that's got 118,000 downloads, and you know, these they've been pretty successful, these things. But you know, with ASP.NET Core, it really kind of changed the world. For example, you know, I work on the ASP.NET team, and we're shipping templates for these different tools and editors. So for example, we've got Visual Studio 2017. VS for Mac, we've got .NET New, and then we have YoASP.NET, which is our Yeoman generator. And each one of these has their own like template format, and you know, you'll create a template in a certain way, and then you'll share a template in like a very specific way.
And they're not all the keeping them in sync across all of the different
ones. Yeah, right, exactly. And let me tell you what, you know, I mean, creating a template for Visual Studio and maintaining that template is incredibly difficult. Like, you wouldn't imagine how difficult it is. Even with Sidewaffle, it's still like very error prone. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we heard feedback saying, hey, you know, I want to be able to create templates across these different projects. And we also heard a lot of feedback saying it's too difficult to create templates and it's too difficult to maintain templates. Maintenance is the real problem. Mm-hmm. So then we took a step back and we said, hey, you know, we wanted to create a tool that's going to enable us to create templates for these different tools and then also make it easier to create these templates. So comes in now the template engine, which is an open source project that we're working on. We've been working on it for probably about a year, actually. And the idea is that you'll create a single template and then you'll ship that as a NuGet package. And then you'll be able to leverage that from .NET New, from Visual Studio for Mac, also YoASP.NET, and then you can add as many arrows as you need here. This is really just a starting point. And right now, we've plugged in the template engine into .NET New, and my team's working on plugging it into Visual Studio, and then hopefully at some point we'll then get the integration for VS for Mac, and community members are working on the YoASP.NET side of the house as well.
Okay.
So what I wanted to do today was basically show you how to create a template, and then how to use .NET New, and then how to exercise your template. And then depending on how much time we have, we'll see how much of that we can go through, basically.
Sounds great.
All right, cool. All right, so demo. So now let's go into using .NET New. Let me clear everything out. All right, so we don't have anything in this folder now. Mm-hmm. To start exploring .NET New, we can use the dash H option here. And then that'll go ahead and give us some help. And you can see we've got a list option here. And then today it actually spits out the template list. But later on, we'll change that to not spit out the template list by default.
OK. So I can ask for the list if I need it, but it doesn't spit
out. Yeah, exactly. To ask for the list, you'll say .NET new dash L, and then you'll see the template list.
OK.
And then we also have template specific help. So if I wanted to look at the MVC template, I can do .NET new MVC dash H. And then here, now I can get into the template specific parameters here. So I can see it's got an authentication option that defaults to none. It has a use local DB option, which defaults to false. So we use SQLite mm-hmm. cross-platform by default here. And then also a framework option here. All right, what I'm going to do is just go ahead and create a console app. And then I'm going to start building on top of that one. That's .NET new console. And then for the output, I want the output to go into a folder called c9.demo. And if you give it an output name, that's also the project name.
Oh, right.
Okay. Which is basically the name of your project. And then if I were to look at the contents of this program.cs, we can see that my namespace has been changed to c9.demo here.
Right, okay.
I can restore and run this. And it should print hello world. Let's take a look. All right. So that's going to restore. So now we've got our hello world here. Nice. So now I'm going to open this guy up in Visual Studio Code. So this is that same folder that I had opened up. Now I'm just going to go ahead and create a template out of this. Creating a template is pretty simple. And the model that we have is your template should always be runnable. So the crux of the problem of maintaining templates is the fact that you take an existing set of code and then you modify it to become your template.
You turn it into a template language not really the same thing. Right.
So now you have two things to maintain. Mm-hmm. So basically the idea behind the template engine is your source is a template.
Okay.
So instead of going in normally what I would do when I was creating a template, I'd go in and I would change this namespace to some type of token.
Dollar sign, whatever.
Right, like dollar sign root namespace or whatever it is, right? But instead of that, we kind of flipped that around. We said, hey, instead of modifying your source, you just add a file and you tell us what needs to be replaced.
Okay.
And then we'll process it. So that's the style here. So I'm going to add a new folder. It has to be called .template.config. And then I'm going to add a file into that. It's called template.json. And then I'm going to open up my other window here that has the actual content, and then we'll walk through this. There. All right, so I've pasted in my JSON from the existing from an existing template that I have, but it was created for this. Most of the fields are pretty self-explanatory, so I'll leave them as they are. There's two items I want to talk about here: the short name. So this is the name that users are going to use from the command line. So we saw .NET new MVC. That's a short name for something that's longer. You know, we have an identity field.
Okay.
And then the source name here is the important part. So c9.demo. What that means is that's the name of my project. And if there's a file that has that name, that file name will get replaced with the user's project name.
And the namespace.
Yeah, and wherever this particular string shows up, it will get replaced.
Okay.
So that's all I had to do. So now I'm going to go into .NET new and enable this template, and then we're going to exercise that template.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to copy the path to this file. And then let me change my folders as well. Oops. So let me change my folder to go into C9. I'll show that there's nothing here. Okay, so the syntax is .NET new --- install folder path. And in the current release, we have a bug that it shouldn't end with slash, so I'm going to remove that slash. Okay, so I've installed it, and then in the template list, I can see I've got my C9 starter web, and the C9 starter web comes right from here, from the name.
Okay.
So now...
That's the full name.
That's the full name. Yeah. No, that's okay. Really that's the human-friendly name. The
got
full
it.
Name is the identity.
Got it.
Yeah,
okay,
exactly
makes sense.
Right. Yep. So .NET new C9 web, and then I'll say the output should be C9.demo. Okay, let's take a look. Catprogram.cs. Still the same stuff. So let me go through and I'll make a change to that file. Let's say the program.cs, hello world from John and Syed. All right, let me go back. I'm just going to make it into another folder here, demo 2. Program.cs.
Ah, okay.
You notice I didn't even have to make that call for .NET new. I didn't have to do anything.
Install it again.
Yeah,
whatever.
Exactly. You only need to call install if that metadata file changes.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's always looking at that folder, and every invocation for .NET new will get that folder basically.
Wow. Okay.
And there's a similar command to install a NuGet package as well.
Okay.
All right. So that's.
And is that how then you've just created that template that you're using locally out of a folder? If you wanted to publish that, you publish that by creating a NuGet package?
That's right. That's right.
Okay.
Yeah, you would publish that as a NuGet package. And at the end of the talk, I'll show you that we have several community members who've already created these NuGet packages, and they're sharing them on NuGet.
Nice.
And they have instructions for how to use it with .NET new.
Cool.
But yeah, exactly. That's the idea.
Okay.
Yep. All right, so now what I want to do is we've just created a console application.
Oops. If I fade back and forth, it gets us like halfway between.
Oh, yeah, right. So now what I want to do is we've created a console application. I want to add a unit test to this.
Okay.
So let's see what that experience might look like. So let me switch back to my temp.net new. All right, so let me go into the C9 demo. Let's see what we have here. Okay, so All right, so let me go up one folder. I'm going to create a new test project.
Okay.
And that's .NET new XUnit. And I'll say the output should be c9.demo.test. Let's take a look at what we have. Now we have two projects here, right?
Demo and demo.test.
That's right. Yeah. So now what I'm going to do is, earlier you saw me create this template config file and then a template.json file. Mm-hmm. And with Visual Studio, you know, creating a single project template is one thing, and then creating a multi-project template
where they're linked
is a
together.
Totally different
right.
thing.
Right.
And it's
nightmare.
It's like orders of magnitude more difficult. So what I'm going to do is take this template config file and move it up one level. Maybe I can't do that from there, actually. Yeah, here we go. All right, so I'm going to take this. Actually, just going to copy it and then paste it here and then delete this guy.
Okay.
All right, so I just moved it up a level, basically, right? So now what I'm going to do is I made that call to .NET new install. So let me go back, and I'm going to make that call again, but now I'm just going to go up one folder.
Okay.
I just moved everything. I just moved that folder
kind of
up one level basically, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Right. So now I'm going to go back to my channel 9 folder. I'm just going to remove everything. Back to a clean directory here.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to make that same exact call that I made before for .NET new C9 web. We've got our C9 web. Now I've got
great.
My
great. So you just created a multi-project template.
Exactly right.
In like
right.
seconds.
That's right. And I haven't actually linked these together, but you know, assuming that you had a project reference, obviously all that stuff's going to work as
right.
well. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So we've made creating templates very, very simple. And whether it's a single project template or a multi-project template. And you know, these templates could also be creating solution files. There's mm-hmm. an F# template that's available for creating solution files. And you know, what I've showed you guys is really just like the one minute demo.
Right.
You know, we're just really scratching the surface here, but there's really a lot of basically time savers in this template engine. You know, like our replacements happen in a particular way that, you know, the namespace can only contain certain characters and the name of the class can only contain certain characters.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll make those changes in the appropriate ways, basically.
Right.
And then users don't really have to think about it.
Okay.
And then the other aspect is, you know, this template engine is not limited to .NET Core or even .NET necessarily. You can create any type of templates with the template engine.
It's text and replacements. Okay.
Yeah, exactly right.
Can you show us where to go to find out more about this?
Yeah, of course. So the main place is .NET. It's on GitHub. So github.com/.NET/templating. And you know, I told you before that we had some available templates that have been created by the community. We're tracking that list here in the wiki here under available community
wow.
templates. I think there's about 12 or 13, maybe even more now. I don't know if you've heard about the ASP.NET MVC boilerplate
yeah,
template
that's great.
From Mohammed.
Uh-huh.
But he was one of the first community guys that we reached out to because he's got a very popular existing Visual Studio extension.
Right, right.
So he's actually created...
So he's created that. Like before, it was always a Visual Studio installer,
right.
and this now makes it available on any platform then.
That's right, that's right.
Wow.
Yep.
Very
it's pretty,
cool.
It's pretty fantastic, man. And I've got some additional resources here for folks as well if they wanted to check out any additional content here. And
great. Well, I'll make sure to get these from you, and we'll get them in the show notes as well.
Yeah, right. So. Thanks. I appreciate that.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Well, thanks a bunch.
Yeah, John. All right, man.